I'm here at the Cupmasters Barbershop in Oxnard, where boxing stars come to get their haircuts, like Kelly Pavlik, like Roger Romo, Brandon Rios, and others. Who's the greatest Mexican fighter of all time?
Without a question. Julio César Chávez.
Not Salvador Sanchez?
Salvador Sanchez didn't really get to live a full life. It was sad, but I mean, who knows what happened if he would have never died. Chavez, I mean, of course, he saw what he did. He's a legend.
He's a legend?
Oscar De La Hoya, come on, man. He's up there too, man.
He's up there, but he's not Chavez.
Is De La Hoya the greatest Mexican-American fighter?
Maybe. Maybe.
Who?
He already destroyed Chavez twice.
He destroyed Chavez twice.
Yeah.
Yeah, you gotta give him his props.
Chavez was 102 years old.
It don't matter.
Yeah, it does.
It was too big, too fast. There's videos of Chavez sparring De La Hoya when Chavez was in his prime, and Chavez dropped him with a body shot on that one.
So don't give me that nonsense.
And that's what Big does. Dropped him with a body shot.
You saw that video? How did it look? Bad?
Oscar was only like 15, 16 years old at the time. And it was a original sparring session.
15, 16.
Hair and everything. You know, it was years ago, but I didn't see it.
No, he was older than that. He was already pro.
Really?
He was already pro, yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah, because he started off at 132.
I call bullshit.
He was at 130.
I'll try to find that video.
You think that Oya was going to be weighing 135 when he was 16, if that's what he weighed when he fought in the Olympic Games? You know what I'm saying?
Hey, sparring is not fighting.
It's bigger gloves.
You could be
It's bigger gloves, and he dropped them with a body shot. And you saw what Hopkins did when he hit him with a body shot.
Sparring is not fighting.
Sure isn't, but you dropped them on the body shot.
Right, Kelly? Sparring is not fighting.
Yeah, you know what? It's only different things.
You could look terrible in sparring, but then go in there and look great in a fight.
What happened when they had 8-ounce gloves on and he fought Chavez? Chavez obviously didn't drop him, did he? Let me recollect.
How old was Chavez?
I believe Chavez got stopped.
How old was Chavez? Was he in his prime?
Hey,
was he in his prime?
Hey, Ellie, come here.
Did Chavez get stopped?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Was he in his prime?
Okay. No, don't matter. He wouldn't have got stopped in this round. He just got beat up for 12 rounds.
You're an idiot.
Too fast, too quick.
Wait, so Roger, if your logic is, okay, he got stopped because he was old, right?
He's done already.
Okay, so what if he would have won? What would you say, he won because he was old?
Nah.
What would you say then?
I said he pulled off a miracle because he was already old. Chavez was done to me. To me, Chavez was done after the Pernell Whitaker fight. After the Pernell Whitaker fight, that was
the best struggle with speed. Struggle with Belgian Taylor was nowhere near. He was faster than De La Hoya, but he was nowhere near as technically sound as De La Hoya.
Tommy struggled against Juan Laporta too.
Yeah, Juan Laporta.
So you're saying De La Hoya was better overall?
Yeah.
And better legacy?
Yeah, and he was bigger. He was a lot taller. Fat. Damn.
I don't think this kid knows the difference between a left hook and a fishing hook.
Do you know the difference between a...
Did you put Rogan on this guy's head?
Do you know the difference between a fish hook and a left hook?
I think one of them's thrown in boxing, the other one's thrown into water to catch fish.
So there we have it. Cupmasters in Oxnard, where the boxing stars come to get their haircuts. FaceNewReporting.com, I'm Melissa Beck reporting.